Welcome back to another edition of Fly Tying with Jim Ashura. Today I'm going to tie another one of Jack Gartside's flies. And this is going to be his cased caddis. The hook that I have in the vise is a Lively Legs Lip Splitter, number 475, size 12. This is a nymph hook, one extra strong and three extra long. You can tie these down to, I wouldn't go smaller than a 14, but 10, 12, 14 is probably a good size for a cased caddis. I'm going to use some, doesn't really matter what color thread you use, but I'm going to use an olive thread. This is like olive gray, but this is a Vivus. I'm going to start out by putting some lead-free wire on there for weight. Case caddis are going to be on the bottom. I'm going to use 20/1000 lead-free wire, and I'm going to do the whole, I'm going to cover the whole hook shank. Leave a little bit on the end there. Go ahead and remove that excess. This lead-free wire doesn't break as easily as lead wire. Lead wire, you could actually pull it and then helicopter it off and it'll come off nice and clean right to the hook shank itself, but not all states allow the use of lead. I'm going to take my thread. I'm going to make cover the lead, kind of hold it there because your thread will actually push the lead wires if you're not careful. And then once you get that covered, you can break off your excess. When you try to break off your line like that, instead of cutting it, you just have to have it secured tight and tight wrapped around your finger. Just gonna go back and forth on this several times. I kind of want to close up as many of the lead, the gaps in the lead as possible. And we're gonna come back. I bent the barb down, but just want that right around the point, or maybe where the barb should have been. Going to start out, I have a chartreuse yarn, a small chartreuse yarn, and this is going to actually represent the head of the caddis, more or less the head of the caddis. I'm just going to fold it over, because once you get using this, this yarn is going to unravel, so it'll all be one piece. Tie that down. Now I'm gonna run my thread up, and this is actually also going to help cover the gaps in the thread. Trim that off. Now the chartreuse thread is my addition to it. What he called for was metallic thread. Doesn't really specify what color, but I would say green would be a good color, since a lot of caddis are green. A lot of caddis shucks are green. I'm just going to fold that over basically almost into a four. So I have it doubled over twice. And I'm going to also just leave that. Let me get it a little longer. Going to tie that in a little bit longer than the chartreuse. Then I'm going to trim it off to the same length as the chartreuse, just to give that a little bit of flash there. Trim off that back. And go ahead and trim off that. So basically I got about four little strands of the metallic thread sticking out there. Now we're also going to use mallard flank. I'm going to use the darker section of this particular one. Just get a few of them, maybe five or six. I'm going to leave them just slightly longer than the chartreuse color. And wrap that in. Wrap that right in. If you could, you know, always wrap in. If you don't have to cut, you don't have to cut. Saves you a little bit. And we're going to bring our thread back to the back. This can be heavy, so it's going to be going down. Now I'm going to take a grizzly hackle. And here I have an olive-dyed grizzly and a brown-dyed grizzly. And I gave them the haircut. I'm going to tie these two in. I want to give them that little haircut, so that first wrap doesn't shoot out. Now I'm going to use a regular grizzly. And it's got the haircut also. Leave a little bit of the crew cut exposed. And then we're going to bring our thread up to the front. This natural grizzly is a little bit shorter of a hackle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap the olive and the brown first. I'm going to wrap these pretty tight. Actually, before I do that, I'm going to utilize my rotisserie feature on my vise. So I'm just going to go and give this give that a quick half hitch and put that thread in my bobbin cradle. If you don't put the thread in the bobbin cradle, I'm sure if you have a rotary vise, you already know it's going to ride up. The thread is going to wrap around the hook shank as you twist it. If you put it in the bobbin cradle, then you're going to have that not do that. I'm going to wrap this. Doesn't really matter. Doesn't have to. I mean, you want to wrap it tight, but it doesn't have to be perfect. I'm going to put my hackle pliers on so I know where the short one is going to end. Probably a good idea to use hackles that are the same size. I'm going to tie this off, although I needed another wrap, a couple of wraps on that brown one. I'm going to go ahead and tie this off because that short feather is already up there. And it doesn't really matter with the color scheme on this very much, because caddis, they make their cases out of just material that's laying on the bottom of the river. It could be rocks, it could be sticks, it could be a lot of things. Take that off. I'm going to go ahead and cut that short one out of there. Take my poke and snip and get it nice and close. And I'm going to wrap a few more times with that longer one and secure that. And then I'm going to wrap the natural grizzly just to try to get a little bit different color mixed in there. You can do other things with these case caddis also. You know, you can put more of one color in there. You don't have to necessarily use grizzly hackle, but you want to kind of mix the colors up. You can put a little short section of one color and then mix them up with another short section of a different color. Because like I said, they just take materials from the bottom of the stream and use them to make their... I'm going to just polymer this because it's kind of... may not even see this when it's done. But I had it tied in. Basically really didn't have enough of that color, but... yeah, that'll work. And I'll trim that off. Then I'm going to take my half hitch tool and free the eye up once, twice. Put that over the eye and push all of that hackle to the back. Clear the eye once, twice. Push that all back there a little bit. And this doesn't even really matter how messy it is with this either. I'm going to go ahead and trim this off. And now you could probably already tell yourself that we're going to trim that, because that's what we're going to do. But I'm going to go ahead and put some head cement on there first, and I got it on the eye. If you suspect you got the glue in the eye, your head cement in the eye, take the feather, trim that stem there nice, and run the feather through the eye of the hook. Goes through pretty easily, and you know it's cleaned out. Now, you want to kind of, you can make this as a taper. Kind of just go all the way around. Make a taper, and even if you don't, if you have some higher spots and some lower spots, like I said, it's going to be fine. There we go, and here we have Gartside's cased caddis. We got the little caddis head, little caddis larva sticking his head out. Got a little bit of that metallic thread to kind of help you get the little bit of flash or attractant there. And got a little antenna or little feelers sticking out. I hope that you learned something from this video. Hope you would subscribe to my channel. Please refer me to your friends. Please visit my sponsors. Leave comments, questions, suggestions. If you'd like to purchase any of these flies, go to my Etsy page, etsy.com/shop/theflyman Jim. And most of all, thank you very much for watching my videos.